Dear students, good morning to all. Welcome to you in your first SSC class of history. So today we start our first chapter of history, name is The Rise of Nationalism in Europe. So chapter 1 deals with many of the issues visualized by Soriot, and we look at the diverse processes through which nation states and nationalism came into being in 19th century Europe. The topics covered in this chapter are rise of nationalism in Europe and French Revolution and nationalism and imperialism. So first here question is, what is meaning of nationalism? So nationalism is an idea and movement that promotes the interests of a particular nation, like us in a group of people, especially with the aim of gaining and maintaining the nation's sovereignty. Sovereignty means self-governance over its homeland. So I hope you all understood meaning of nationalism. So students, please open your history book, and first page you saw a painting. Carefully watch this painting. So this painting is made by in 1848 Frederick Soriot. He was a French artist. Frederick Soriot, a French artist, in 1848 prepared a series of four prints visualizing his dreams of a world made up of democratic and social republics, as he called them. So watch this painting and carefully listen me. So first, Frederick Soriot and his visualization. Okay, so Frederick Soriot, first the first print source of painting. So first print source, the people of Europe and America marching in a long train and offering homage to the Statue of Liberty as they pass by it. A female figure carries a torch of enlightenment in one hand and the Charter of the Right of Man in the other hand. So second Frederick Soriot visualization. On the earth lies the shawl scattered remains of the symbols of absolutistic institution. Okay, so second visualization of Frederick Soriot is, on the earth lies the scattered remains of the symbols and absolute institutions. Okay, and third vision is in Soriot utopian vision. So here word utopian. So in Soriot utopian vision. So utopian means a vision of a society that is so ideal that it is unlikely to actually exist. So the people of the world are grouped as distinct nations, identified through their flag and national costumes. So next four vision of Frederick Soriot is leading the procession are USA and Switzerland. Okay, so fourth visualization is leading the procession and USA and Switzerland, followed by France and Germany. Following Germany are Austria, kingdom of the two Swiss, Lombardy, Poland, England, Ireland, Hungary, and Russia. So fifth vision of Teddy Sorio is from the heavens above. So what is this vision? So in this vision, visualization of Teddy Sorio is Christ saints and angels gaze at the scenes. Since the artist symbolize fraternity among the nation of the world. So all of vision, if you saw this picture carefully, so all of vision or visualization of Teddy Sorio you saw in this picture. I hope you understood very well today's topic. Next topic of this chapter we will study in our next video. Thank you for watching.